Hi students, in the previous topic we had discussed about peripheral devices. We need peripheral devices in order to communicate with the CPU. Without peripheral devices, there is no useful purpose of CPU alone. Okay, but these peripheral devices are very much different from the CPU, and because of that we need an interface. So let us come to the present topic, input-output interface. What is this interface? Why do we need this interface? Okay, that is the topic. Initially, we will look at the differences between peripheral devices and CPU. The major differences are, first one is, many of the peripheral devices are either the manner of operation of the peripheral device is either electromechanical or electromagnetic or electro-optical. Okay, so, but the CPU is purely electrical. So, this is one major difference. This conversion of signals is required, and the second reason is the data transfer rate of these peripheral devices and CPU is different. Peripheral devices are very slow and CPU is very much faster than them. So some kind of synchronization is required, synchronization mechanism is needed for the data transfer between these peripheral devices and CPU. The third reason is the data codes and formats used in peripheral devices differs from the word formats of the CPU and memory. Okay, and the last reason is operating modes of the peripheral device are different from each other, and we need an interface to ensure that one peripheral device will not disturb the other peripheral device. So because of these major differences, there is a need of interface. Okay, let us look at the connection of I/O bus to input-output devices. This is the processor, CPU, and these are the peripheral devices, keyboard, a display, printer, magnetic disk, magnetic tapes. So these are the various input and output devices which are connected to processor through an interface. If you look at here, each and every peripheral device is having its own interface. Each and every peripheral having its own interface, because same interface cannot be used for all the peripheral devices. Now keyboard is sending 8-bit words to the processor, whereas printer is receiving commands from the processor. This is input device, this is output device, and it will print on a paper, whereas here mechanical action of the user must be converted into electrical information. Similarly, magnetic disk, so the data will be converted into magnetic form, or while reading the data from the magnetic disk, the magnetic form must be converted into electrical form. So each and every peripheral device requires a distinct interface. Okay, there are many different types of interfaces are available. So peripheral devices are connected to processor through this interface. Okay, and here you can see the I/O bus, input output bus. Okay, I/O bus consists of data lines, address lines, and I/O control lines like I/O read, I/O write. Okay, so this is the I/O bus. Now let us look at an example interface, an example input-output interface, and its block diagram. Okay, this is the block diagram of example interface unit. Okay, so this interface unit will be the mediator between CPU and I/O device. So we are assuming that CPU is existing on the left side of the peripheral device and I/O device is existing on the right side of the interface. So in between the CPU and this I/O device, this peripheral device is existing. Now the CPU will communicate with the I/O device through this interface. Okay, so how the CPU communicates with the I/O device? It communicates using I/O commands, input-output commands. There are four different types of I/O commands: control command, status command, output data, input data. Okay, let us look at the control command. Control command is used to initiate the peripheral device, input-output device, and status and control command also tells the I/O device what to do. For example, if the I/O device is a printer, then it will tell the printer to print some kind of information. Or if diver device is a magnetic tape, then it will the control command will be telling the magnetic tape to go to certain song before playing it. Okay, let us look at the second diver command, that is status. So status command is used to test the status conditions, to know the condition of the IO device before giving any order to it, any command to the IO device. And sometimes the work given to the IO device might not be completed, so to know the status of the work that is assigned to the IO device is also this status command is used. And output data, sometimes the CPU data is given by the CPU to the IO device. For example, if the IO device is a pen drive, so if you want to transfer some kind of MP3 player or a video, then this output data will be, command will be used. Sometimes we will be receiving the data from the IO device, then this input command will be used. Okay. All these commands are given to this interface, and this interface will make sure the data transfer between the CPU and IO device happens without any difficulty. Whatever the conversions required, data format adjustments required, speed synchronizations required will be done by this peripheral IO interface. Here you can see the its function table. CS means chip select. With the help of chip select, this interface will be activated by the processor. If there is no use of, if the processor is not interested in this IO device, then this interface will not be activated. If it wants to use this IO device, first it should activate this interface through this chip select. Once this interface is selected, activated, now out of these four operations, four commands, on control command, status command, input out, output data, input data, so one of these four commands will be given, and that will be given with the help of RS1 and RS0. These are called register select pins. So there are two pins, so total 2 to the power of 2 operations can be controlled. 2 to the power of 2 is 4. And IO operations, IO read or IO write. IO read means data is incoming to the CPU. IO write means data is outflowing from the CPU. Okay, this is the bus buffer which will be receiving either data from the CPU or from the IO device. It is an intermediate register. So this is the internal block diagram of an example interface. All the interfaces might not be exactly similar, but the most of the interfaces will be looking like this. So this kind of interface is required to communicate with the CPU. This interface will make sure that CPU and IO devices will communicate without having any difficulty. If you get any doubt why do we need this interface, just look at these four reasons. One is the peripheral device working mechanism is different from the CPU, and their speeds are different, synchronization is definitely required, data codes and formats are different, operating modes are also different. Thank you.